In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, Adding and Subtracting Radical Expressions. Our directions for this worksheet are to simplify. Now, adding and subtracting radical expressions is similar to adding or subtracting fractions. However, with fractions, the denominator has to be the same in order to add and subtract. But with radical expressions, what is within the radical has to be the same in order to add or subtract. So looking at number 1, we have 3 times the square root of 6 minus 4 times the square root of 6. Because these radicals are similar, we can simply subtract 3 minus 4 and then multiply it by the radical. So 3 minus 4 is negative 1, and that will get multiplied to the square root of 6. A negative 1 times the square root of 6 is simply negative square root of 6. So that's our answer in number 1. Let's move on to number 2. In number 2, we have negative 3 times the square root of 7 plus 4 times the square root of 7. The square root of 7 is the same. So essentially, we're going to do negative 3 plus 4, which is a positive 1. So we'll get 1 times the square root of 7, which 1 times any number is simply that number that's multiplied by 1. So this answer will be the square root of 7. Now, here's another way to think about it if you want to use variables. Let's set the square root of 7 equal to a. So if the square root of 7 equals the variable a, we'll plug a in, so we'll have negative 3a plus 4a, and negative 3a plus 4a will be a positive 1a, which we write as a. However, remember back at the beginning, we said that a was the square root of 7, therefore negative 3a plus 4a equals 1a, or in other words, equals a, and a is the square root of 7, so that's our answer. In number 3, we have negative 11 times the square root of 21 minus 11 times the square root of 21. So we're taking negative 11 and subtracting 11 more, so that's going to be negative 22, and then we're multiplying that by the square root of 21. So negative 22 times the square root of 21. Now again, if we wanted to think about this in terms of variables, we could set x equal to the square root of 21. So then we'd have negative 11x minus 11x, which was equal to negative 22x, and then we'll plug x back in to get negative 22 times the square root of 21. That's how you can think about it with variables. However, let's think about it using reverse distribution. If we have negative 11 times the square root of 21 minus 11 times the square root of 21, let's pull out the square root of 21. So that expression would become the square root of 21 times negative 11 minus 11, which would be the square root of 21, and then we'd multiply that by negative 11 minus 11, which is negative 22, and because multiplication is commutative, I can write that as negative 22 times the square root of 21. So those are just a couple different ways to think about adding and subtracting radical expressions. So if you need to, feel free to write it out in either way. In number 4, I have the square root of 15 in common, and I have negative 9 plus 10. Negative 9 plus 10 is going to be a positive 1, so that will be 1 times the square root of 15, which equals the square root of 15. What's in my radical is similar. 7 is in both of my square roots. So I'll simply add those coefficients together. Negative 10 plus 12 will be a positive 2, and I'll still multiply that by the square root of 7. So 2 times the square root of 7 is my solution in number 5. In number 6, we have negative 3 times the square root of 17 minus 4 times the square root of 17. Negative 3 minus 4 will be a negative 7, and we're still multiplying that by the square root of 17. That's my solution in number 6. And if you wanted to think about this as reverse distribution, simply take negative 3, subtract 4, and that will get multiplied to the square root of 17 because I pulled the square root of 17 out of each term. Negative 3 minus 4 is negative 7, and we're multiplying that by the square root of 17. In number 7, I have negative 10 times the square root of 11 minus 11 times the square root of 11. This time I'll use substitution to solve. I'll set the square root of 11 equal to a. So I'll have negative 10 times a minus 11 times a. Negative 10a minus 11a is going to be negative 21a, and then I'll plug in my value of a to get negative 21 times the square root of 11. That's my solution in number 7. Now in number 8, we're going to be switching things up a bit. I do not have the same number within my radical, so I'm going to have to simplify 3 times the square root of 27 so that I get a 3 within my radical in order to combine those terms. So I'll have negative 2 times the square root of 3 plus, is there any perfect square that can go into 27? Yes, 27 is equal to 3 times 9, where that can be written as 3 times 3 squared. So in order to simplify this radical, I'll rewrite it as 3 times the square root of 3 squared times 3. 3 squared times 3 is still 27, but it allows me to pull out a 3. So I'll have negative 2 times the square root of 3 plus 3 times 3 times the square root of 3. And that's because this exponent of 2 will get canceled out when under the square root. So I would just pull out that base of 3. Now I'll have negative 2 times the square root of 3 plus 3 times 3 is 9, and multiplying that by the square root of 3. Negative 2 times the square root of 3 plus 9 times the square root of 3, I have the same number within my radical, so I'll be able to add those together. Negative 2 plus 9 is a positive 7, so my solution is 7 times the square root of 3. And number 9, again I'm going to have to simplify my radical within my second term in my expression. 2 times the square root of 24. I can simplify 24 because I know that 24 is 6 times 4. So I'll get that radical of 6 because 4 is a perfect square. 6 times 2 squared is 24. So I'll rewrite number 9 as 2 times the square root of 6 minus 2 times the square root of 6 times 2 squared. So I'll have 2 times the square root of 6 minus 2 times, and I'll be able to pull out this base of 2 because my exponent will get canceled out within that square root. So I'll have 2 times 2 times the square root of 6. So that'll be 2 times the square root of 6 minus 2 times 2 is 4, and then I'm still multiplying that by the square root of 6. Now you can see I have the same number within my radical, so essentially my radicals are equivalent, so I can take 2 times the square root of 6 and subtract 4 times the square root of 6 to get negative 2 times the square root of 6, because 2 minus 4 is negative 2, but I'm still multiplying that to the square root of 6. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 10. In number 10, we need to simplify 54 so that it's 6 times some number because I want it to match this radical of 6. 54, I know, is equal to 6 times 9, and 9 is a perfect square. That's 6 times 3 squared. So I'll have 2 times the square root of 6 plus 3 times the square root of 6 times 3 squared. Now I'll be able to pull out my base of 3 since it has an exponent of 2. And if you're confused on why I can do that, refer back to the previous worksheet where I just went over simplifying radical expressions. But continuing on, I'm going to be pulling out a 3, again since it has an exponent of 2. So I'll have 2 times the square root of 6 plus 3 times 3 times the square root of 6. So that's 2 times the square root of 6 plus 3 times 3 is 9, and I'm still multiplying that by the square root of 6. 2 plus 9 is 11, so I'll get 11 times the square root of 6 as my final solution in this video. Join me in the next video where I'll continue on with the next 10 problems of this worksheet, completing numbers 11 through 20. However, before you continue on, click that like button and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below.